Oh, hello. So you probably have already seen my last video on the first column, which is high level performance, hard skills for the chief of staff. And in this video, we're going to get into the elite level performance, hard skills for a chief of staff. And these are a little bit more advanced. So you can see them in the right hand column. So number one, executive team management. The chief of staff needs to manage the executive team, making sure that they're meeting on the right cadence, enabling them to be great at their job by promoting cross-functional collaboration and communication, making sure that they are getting along and collaborating in the right way through offsites and culture building. Executive team management is important often because the CEO doesn't have enough time to manage their entire executive team. Second, change management. This is more for larger enterprises, but you would imagine that there are many enterprise level strategic initiatives that need to be executed. So whether it's implementing a new company-wide communication software or changing the recruiting practice principles and process, whatever it might be, the chief of staff needs to be a guide and a shepherd for some of these big change initiatives, and they need to manage that through their change management. Third, investor and board management. The chief of staff needs to be confident in interfacing with these stakeholders and also create the right materials for this audience. Oftentimes, folks with a strong consulting background or obviously a financial services background are quite comfortable interfacing with the investor and the board. They know what type of materials and what narrative to create and can really help their leader, the CEO, with investor and board management. And brings me to number four, which is financial acumen. Of course, if you're creating investor decks and board decks, you need to have that financial acumen to be able to create the charts that go into those decks. But beyond those decks, financial acumen is super helpful for a chief of staff that's maybe trying to ascertain what the ROI is on going into a new market or taking on a new initiative. They can actually use strategic planning using financial acumen. There's many ways that a chief of staff can really leverage strong Excel skills and modeling skills to be able to inform some of the decisions that they're making on behalf of their CEO. That brings us to the second to last one, which is culture management. So the chief of staff can be a really great steward of culture. They can take the values and the principles of the leader and also endorse them, showcase them, and model them as they go around the company. And so the chief of staff can be really an evangelist or a proponent of those values. The last one, which is executive coaching. So of course you have to be a more senior chief of staff to be able to coach your CEO, but in essence, that's what you're doing every single day. You are advising them on strategic matters, and you are also serving as a trusted confidant. And so my spiky point of view is that the chief of staff is providing executive coaching at a very, very low rate, and they are providing much more value than, say, an external executive coach who charges thousands of dollars. This is really where the chief of staff can provide a lot of value. They are there by the side of their leader day in, day out. So there you have it. Those are the six elite level performance hard skills of the chief of staff. And I will catch you on the next video. Thanks.